science demonstration this morning. It's entitled Abiding in Christ, and it was something I really enjoyed doing the other day as I was figuring out how to shuffle books, and I'm going to teach you how to shuffle books. But it's a very important lesson, and it's based on this text in John 15:7, slide number 2. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Now, we love that promise. It's a beautiful promise. It's a promise to God's people. Let's move on to slide 3. In this demonstration, all you need are 2 paperback books about the same size. And I brought some books with me that I've already done this little demonstration. But I'm going to show you how to do it. And so this particular book, shall I move over here? This particular book is put together, but we can open it up and pull it apart. So that's what I want to do now, is to open these 2 books up and show you what we're talking about when we mention shuffling books. Now, we want to shuffle these pages together, pardon me, but they won't go together unless unless you start carefully. The back cover and the front, the 2 back covers need to overlap each other. And then you just slowly move some pages down from one book, from the other book, back and forth. It doesn't have to be exact. It's not every one page. Put a few pages here, a few pages from the left, a few pages from the right. We are slowly shuffling the pages of this book together. Now you want to choose books that are similar in size. They can be big books, they can be little books, but we want to shuffle these pages together. And then, I don't have Ashley with me, that was too many pages, to ask her to pull these apart. And you can do this at home. Now, when you get to the end, it's a little bit tricky to make sure you don't lose any pages here. Now, we're done. But I don't have Ashley with me to pull these apart. I'll have to show you that it would seem simple. We've got 2 books put together like this. And they're small books. But I cannot pull them apart. And since Pastor is here helping on the other end of our technical know-how, I'm going to ask him to step around here and see if he can pull these books apart. Now, I don't want you to tear the books. They're from my library. So if you can pull them apart, go right ahead.
Well, I'm sure I can pull these apart. They're small books.
Go right ahead. Oh, don't fake it. Just pull it.
I'm pulling. You really mean you want me to pull them apart?
That's right. Oh, he did it. Oh, I'm impressed, I guess. Well, here are 2 books that are bigger. I did these last night or the night before. They're larger books, see? And let's see if you can get these apart. And then I'll show you some pictures.
The others were hard to pull, and I had to vibrate them.
Oh, no, it's not fair to vibrate. You have to just pull straight.
I'm pulling straight, and they will not come apart.
They won't. Right. Okay. Now, this is to illustrate God abiding in us. He wants to be with us, interwoven into our lives so tightly that nothing can separate us from the love of God. Now, let's look at slide number 4. The procedure is you just shuffle the pages together. And remember, I had these other 2 books together, and I wanted to show you how to do it. So I had to break the connection apart and let some air in there, and then you can pull them apart. Slide 5 shows 2 books of similar size. One looks a little larger than the other. Slide 6 shows a person doing the same thing that I just showed you to do, to shuffle those pages. After you get the back covers together, you start shuffling pages. Slide 7 shows almost finished with this larger section of 2 books put together. Slide 8 shows the books finished. They've been shuffled. You cannot pull these apart. I don't know, care if you're Mr. America. Something this size cannot be pulled apart by human beings. Now, there was a show, I didn't see it, but I read about it online, where this very feat was tried. I don't know, some kind of incredible whatever. Nobody could pull them apart. They had to, it was two phone books, I believe, that had been shuffled together. Two cars couldn't pull them apart. They had to get a tank on one end and a Sherman something or other on the other end. And finally they could pull them apart, but not just pulling the books apart. They tore the books apart to get them to separate. And that's why if you do this at home and you take two books from your library, you don't want to twist and turn because you could tear the pages. The illustration is to pull them apart with equal force going straight out, not to twist them. So we want to go to slide 9. Now, this illustrates also true love. And here's a little quotation that might be appropriate for the young adults in our lives who may be listening and contemplating sharing a life with someone else. True love is phrased in service and in a deep understanding of the other. It's a love that continues rather than a love that just happens. It's a love that is after the image of peace rather than after the image of tension. And a love of permanence rather than a love for the moment. And those of us who are adults and a little more, I have lived a little longer, realize that, you know, this thing that this impulse that we call love can fade away. It's not a permanent thing. It's not something that continues rather than just happens based on feelings. So true love, and Ellen White gives us some very good counsel about what true love, it's a principle. And when we look at our books, when God loves us, He doesn't separate from us. And this is why I'm using this illustration, because we're going to soon move into the experience of the Israelites after the Exodus. We want to finish up our lesson that we've been dwelling on for a few weeks. God wanted to be close to His people. He didn't want them to murmur and complain and separate from Him. And He will. Now, another thing to remember is these two books are together. There's important information in each book. And when two people merge their lives, for example, they don't lose their personality. They don't lose who they are and just become an automaton or a replica of the other person. It's an intermingling of both lives with personalities that stay the same, but they're all under the control of Jesus Christ. And He wants to interweave into our lives like this also. Now, slide 10 shows a way to release. The only way to get this book apart, other than tearing it apart with extreme pressure, is to open it up and to release the pressure that has built up. Now, I wanted to explain why. See how these spines, they're smaller than what the pages are, and they're exerting some pressure on those pages. So every page, the pressure that's on the bottom page is great because every page above it has more pressure being added to it. And that's what keeps it from being pulled apart, this inertia, this friction, so to speak, that's in there. But the only way to get them apart is to break to put a barrier in there. And that's what the Israelites were doing. They were separating from God with their murmuring and complaining. God wanted to take care of them, provide food and water for them in the wilderness, but their complaining and their attitude of not trusting God put a barrier between what He wanted to build in for His people. And so we don't want barriers to come among us in God's church. We want to settle differences. We're entreated to go to one another and to work things out and not to harbor bitterness and hostility, but in the love of God to live in peace. Now, the next slide, slide 11, shows two telephone books that have been put together. This is time consuming, but someone has done that. Slide 12 shows two men trying to pull it apart, and it's impossible to pull apart for them. Now, slide 13 gives us the explanation. All that's holding the two books together was friction. When you interleave the books, there is a small force pulling the two books together created by the spines of the books. The spines slightly compress the interleaved pages, and there is a friction force at every point the pages are interleaved created by this compression. For example, if there are 50 interleavings, when you shuffle the books and there are 50 interleavings, the small frictional force will be multiplied by 50 to create a huge force that you cannot overcome by muscle. Now, slide 15 tells us, I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, or things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. When we let Jesus into our lives, He will help us in every difficulty. We don't need to wish to be separated. We won't lose who we are. We won't lose our love of music or the talents that He's given us or our love of reading and for Him and writing like we do a lot in the work that I'm in. We don't lose that. He magnifies that. He helps us. And so there's nothing. We don't want anything to separate us, but we can walk away. But if we stay there, Jesus will never walk away from us. All right, that ends our science demonstration for this week. We hope that you will join us next week for whatever might be. We shall see.